How's it going, everyone? The Trout91 here for a Friday commentary. I bet you'll find it's been a while since I did one of these, and it's probably been a while since I did an actual video, because I have to say, I have been one busy, busy bumblebee over the past few weeks. I have got so much coursework to do, and I have had lots of events I've been going to, where have I been? I went to Germany for the Call of Duty Championships, and you might see my game attack a little bit different there. I'll get onto that in a little bit. But, next, where did I go? Then, last weekend I went to Telford for Multiplayer's iSeries I-48, where I actually competed in competitive for once, you know? I've never really done that kind of serious competition before. You know, I've done the game battle stuff back in the day and all sorts, but I've never actually gone to a LAN event and competed properly with a team. So it was a huge, huge experience, and I'd went to I-47, which was fun, but I didn't really do much there, so there wasn't much I could report on. I tried desperately hard to get some footage for you guys of our games, where, and I have to say, the one thing I was most, like, worried about was going to this event and underperforming, and I think that overall I performed incredibly, incredibly well. And I went absolutely massive in quite a few games. Search and Destroy seemed to be my best game mode. It's always been one that I've excelled at. Hardpoint was a bit iffy at times, and then Capture the Flag I was kind of dreadful at. But overall, we did really well. I was playing with Extreme Academy, playing with Defiant Eurasian and a girl called Emily, who was our pickup because one of our regular guys couldn't make it. And we all had a really good time. I think our team has not won a single game in 2 years, and we actually won our first two games and finished second in our group out of the group stage of the competition. But unfortunately, we lost against Prophecy, who are probably the best team in the UK. It wasn't an absolute massacre, I wouldn't say, but it wasn't exactly a competition. And then we lost our bracket deciding game, and then we lost our losers bracket game in a Search and Destroy 5-all moment. A lot of our Search and Destroys came down to the final round, which is a little bit gutting, but I had a good time. I learned a lot about competitive gaming, and I can see the addiction, so much so that I ended up doing sprinkler celebrations when I'd kill people or win the round or something like that. And it's kind of what I wanted to talk about. So that's why my gamertag is XA Trout, is because of Extreme Academy. I made it for the event. And hopefully we might be doing some more events in the future. I'll keep you posted on that. I'd love to get some gameplays of some actual competitive matches. And the problem was the stream actually went down, and there was nothing we could do. There was only one game that got streamed of ours, and it wasn't a very good one. It was one of, I think it was our losers. No, it was our bracket deciding game that got streamed, and we lost that. It wasn't really a very entertaining one. I didn't get on the camera very much. They didn't pick me to spectate out of all of it, but I don't know. I suppose it's good because not much happened, but anyway. I wanted to kind of talk about the competitive scene, because I think it's Call of Duty, and the competitive scene has had a little bit of negative feedback after the whole Eurogamer thing. I was actually at the European Championship qualifiers, you know, to decide who goes to the actual World Championships in LA, which also I should hopefully be attending, so fingers crossed on that one. And I have to say, it was the atmosphere was absolutely electric between the players. It was both a joy to watch and also quite a horrifying thing to watch, because as you saw in that video that the Eurogamer put up, it did paint them all in a very bad and negative light, and I can't really say that that's not how it went down, because a lot of them were very, very rude. There were a couple of times I was pretty sure that a fight was going to break out because of the emotion in the air. But, and I suppose you got to sympathize with the players. You're playing for, at that point, you were playing for a place in the finals where you could potentially win $400,000. For playing a video game. You have to admit that after all the time and the energy and all that kind of stuff that these guys have invested in the game, that you've got to cut them a little bit slack. There's going to be tension running, there's going to be emotions flying in the air, and sometimes people will lose it for a split second, lose their professionalism, and it'll go all tits up. And you can't say that professional athletes don't have those kind of moments. They do, and obviously they get punished for it, but and those guys have been trained almost to do that. And these guys, let's be honest, they haven't. Their training is in playing the game. It's not in how to deal with the social media. And as you could see, a lot of them weren't particularly 100% comfortable talking to the media and being on camera and all sorts of stuff. They're, a lot of them are very, very nice guys. They just got caught up in the moment. And but what you didn't see was all the shaking of hands and all the joking around that these guys had afterwards and in between. Like, we had, after the first day in which we decided who was going to the final championships, there was a nice party afterwards. Everyone was having a good laugh, having a good bit of banter between each other. And it was all in good fun favor, you know, as teams do. Obviously, you leave your emotions out of it. What happens on the pitch, I suppose, is very different to what happens on off the pitch, if that makes sense. And, you know, when I was playing, I actually felt so much energy and emotion and electricity, like, running through me, that at times, you know, I was getting involved. I was like, ah, blah, 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 feed me with a ladle, boys, come on, all this kind of stuff. And genuine smack talking, which is just part of the game. It psychs people out, yes, and I suppose there is a limit to it, you know. You can't be going around. I know a couple of people at the event were actually taking personal insults to people, which is just absolutely out of order. You can't be doing that. There's a limit to it. And I think people like that really do need to check themselves and reevaluate what they're doing. But at the same time, I do feel sympathy for those who kind of, you know, don't necessarily mean what they're saying. They just lose it at the amount of time. And I think especially The Independent wrote an article about it, and they really didn't paint it in a good light, and they really don't understand how much time and energy people invest into this, because it is literally just as important as any professional athlete playing their game and getting emotional about it. And I think now that I've experienced it, I understand where those guys come from and why it's very unfair to paint them in such a negative light over one small situation that pretty much decides a huge fate in their life. It's like they're the biggest moment of their lives, and you're trying to take away something beautiful and make it seem like something ugly. So that's just my two cents on it. I thought I would kind of check in with you guys, because I do miss you a great deal. And I hope you enjoy the commentary. I'll speak to you all later. Peace out.